And action!
I'm a sentimental, very emotional Welshman. With a rather maddening sense of humor. I have a twinkle in my eye, and I think the previous director was a different kind of person, with perhaps a deeper sense of gloom or a deeper sense of doom, and maybe slightly less sense of humor. George is a different man again, with a different kind of an attitude to relationships and so forth. Maybe a little bit more introverted, perhaps a little bit more distant, with maybe therefore a greater sense of action storyline, and perhaps less interest in the way that people interact. For me, this film is about friendship and loyalty and trust and self-identification. But don't take it too seriously. Let's have a laugh about it. But when we're going to cry, let's cry. And when we're going to laugh, let's laugh. And I think that's what, I guess, I brought to this movie, and I like to think that's why I was asked to direct it.
Well, I tell you, Java's getting very good.
Is he?
Yes, he's getting very good. He's almost star now.
Oh, good.
We have to be very nice.
Right through the end of the whole movie.
Really. So you put the putting down to later.
Yes, next. And then the levitation, and then the undoing.
Okay. All right, the actors step in, please.
Those costumes don't just happen by accident. Each individual person has to have their feet, arms, legs, bodies, and heads fitted. And then, when the heads go on, they can barely see, they can barely breathe, they have an enormous lot of energetic acting to do. And you have to be aware while you're playing the scene that the person inside is probably at the point of suffocation just at the moment when you want that extra something from them.
And on a shot of your two hands doing it without throwing the background and just bring him in.
You think that'll work that way?
Yeah, I think it'll work very well.
I'll do it without moving my mouth, so if you decide not to use it.
By the time I actually came to shoot Jedi, I knew Star Wars and Empire backwards and forwards. I knew them extremely well. And I liked the apparent naivete and simplicity with which George had made Star Wars. I liked that style very much.
What is interesting is that when you reflect and you look back at the other movies, and you certainly look at this movie, and you realize how much of the action is propelled or carried by that character, it all makes a lot of sense. And you actually realize that it was actually sitting there staring you in the face. I suspect that probably a lot of younger people will understand that immediately because they're more involved in that type of relationship themselves. They're much more fascinated by who is who. I mean, that is always the great thing that you are fascinated with when you're an adolescent, particularly, I know I was. Is my father really my father? I know I've got another family somewhere else. I hate this family. They won't let me read in bed at night, or they insist that I put my cigarette out, or they won't let me do what I want to do. I'm going to go and live somewhere else because I know this isn't really my dad, and that kind of thing. So I think when we spring this surprise on them, it'll probably come as a very satisfying, as I say, a satisfying tying of a loose end that will be very nice for them. Part 1, 2, and 3, 7, 8, and 9 are yet to be made. And it's a big question mark, and we all hope they will be. And I know that 1, 2, and 3 are in George's mind, because he's actually told me basically what the outlines of those stories are. They involve a much earlier period in time. But he chose to start in the middle. Knowing the convoluted way, or slightly knowing the convoluted way that George's mind works, I suspect that he might go back to the beginning. But it really is not a known fact. I really, really do not know. I only hope that he does do some more.